Saïda from J-Code Laboratory, Department of Computer Science. I'm a PhD student on the third year. Today I will present to you our work, Machine Learning Methods and Deep Learning for Android Malware Detection using permission. Our plan contains an introduction. What is a permission? Our classification steps, Android malware datasets, results and experimentation, and a conclusion. Android mobile platform is the most popular operating system. Today, many important tools and devices have Android as their operating system. It's accounted for more than 50% of smartphone sales in the third quarter of 2011. Google Play has more than 50 billion downloaded applications. It has generated revenues exceeding $5 billion in 2013. Since the version of Android 6.0 Marshmallow launched, Android has granted users control over application permissions. Application permissions means what your app is allowed to do and access. The access is to data stored on your phone, like contacts and media files, also to the camera or the microphone. Allow permission to an application so let the app to use the feature. Denying access prevents it from doing so. Applications, Android application cannot automatically grant themselves permission. They have to be confirmed by the user. Older applications that haven't been updated might crash or fail to work correctly if you deny some permissions. Android application will ask you to accept each of their permissions the first time you launch them via a pop-up that asks you to allow or deny each request. In this diapositive, we have some permissions. We have the body sensors permissions. Allow the applications to access to your health data. We have the calendar permission. Allow the application to read or create or edit from your calendar event. We have the camera permission. Let the application to taking photos and recording videos. We have the permission of contacts. Let the Android application to read or create or edit on your contact list. We have some other permissions. We have the location permissions, the microphone permissions, we have the phone permissions, the SMS permissions, and the storage permissions. An application will always ask you to confirm its permissions the first time you run it. The purpose of a permission is to protect the privacy of an Android user. Denying permission to dodgy apps is one of the best ways to keep your phone on data safe from malicious applications. For example, messaging application will need your contact or SMS or probably your camera permission, but they don't need to access to your health information. You can always check out of all the permission of an application before you install it by checking out the description in the Play Store. A good developer will always know what permission is needed for each type of applications. In our work, we had take the Android malware data sets, and we had experiment and detect malware application based on permission using some algorithm of data mining and deep learning algorithm. The steps follows to classify the applications, even malware or benign application, as are illustrated in the figure. We have the applications as entrée,
entrée. We have the extract the features. We get the vectors to classify them. We apply the classification algorithm to get even
malware or benign application. In our work, we had took the dataset name malware benign permission. It contains 398 applications divided equally. 199 application malware application and 199 benign application. It contained 339 attributes. The last column contained the type of application, even the malware or the benign application. We have identified some parameters of the used algorithms. For gradient boosting classifier, extra trees classifier, and the LSTM recurrent network. For example, for the recurrent neural network, we had used the sigmoid as a function of activation. We had used 64 hidden layers, etc. The results obtained for the used algorithm are illustrated on the table. We had used the SVM algorithm, naive Bayes, Gaussian naive Bayes, the 5NN and 3NN. We have used also decision tree, random forest, extra tree classifier, gradient boosting classifier, ADA boost, and the LSTM recurrent neural networks. The gradient boosting classifier, we have evaluated the results with different measures
like recall,
precision, accuracy and F measure, and entropy. The gradient boosting classifier gave the best recall. And for the other measures, the extra tree classifier gave the best results according to the other algorithms. As a conclusion, according to the wide use of the Android operating systems, many attempts of violation has been appeared to steal and hack sensitive data via permissions. We had selected different algorithms of data mining and deep learning algorithm. And we have evaluated the results of classification of all the algorithms mentioned. The researchers on this field has not ended, and it is necessary to find solution more effective to stop these attempts of intrusions. Thanks for your attention.
Thank you for the presentation. Is there any questions?
Just a question about according to your opinion, what are the most sensitive data that malware are stealing, and what is the main purpose of stealing all this data, according to you?
There is a lot of parameters. Il existe plusieurs paramètres. Par exemple, ce dataset contient 330 colonnes. Chaque colonne contient un type de permission. Par exemple, soit une permission d'image, ou bien une permission de message. Ou bien... Les buts.
Là, parmi les données, les volets. Voilà.
Par exemple,
quels sont les plus sensibles?
Le vol de crédit, par exemple. Il ne jette pas. Un voleur peut voler le crédit.
Là, par exemple, tu mets les contacts.
Par exemple, chez carte Visa. Un crédit de puce.
Crédit de puce.
Crédit de puce.
Et ça,
c'est une série, une violation. C'est une violation. Il existe plusieurs. Chez elle, par exemple, il peut voler des données confidentielles.
Là, selon les statistiques,
oui.
Les données les plus volées.
Ah, les données les plus volées.
C'est les
crédit cards. Chaque crédit card c'est un autre service. ماشي في الاندرويد. فهمتني؟ ممكن في كونت بيبول. ممكن. كريدي كارد. كريدي كارد ماشي في الاندرويد. غير إذا كان لا بونك اللي تتعامل مع لي كليون تاعها عندها اون ابليكاسيون اندرويد. تي بو كونسلتي. كاين لي كونسلتي اون لين سيت.
الابليكاسيون ما يخليوكش تانستالي في التليفون الوتي كيما تاع الجي دي بوست يقعد التليفون الوتي ما يعطيكش
لا سي فري كاين دي بونك عندها ابليكاسيون عندها حاطه دي ديفينيسيون سوالا تي بو با كونسلتي فوتر كونت اون لين فيا اون ابليكاسيون اندرويد كاين ما عندهاش شي كونسلتي فيا ان سيت فهمتني
ديريكتومون
وي